Hello, my name is Rainer Gerhards. I'm the guy who wrote rsyslog and a couple of other logging tools, both on Windows and Linux. I'm also involved in standardization efforts and I'm doing logging since 1995.
Today I want to talk about the rsyslog journal integration that becomes widely available with rsyslog version 7.4 and above. What have we done to integrate with the journal? Actually, there have been two modules being written, one output module and one input module. The output module is OM Journal and it provides the ability to store messages right into the journal. So it works with traditional syslog, messages over the network, text files, database inputs, SNMP input and all these things. And it provides the ability that you use the journal as your backend database, which is probably most interesting for low-end use cases where no enterprise environment is available. And there's also the module IamJournal. It's actually a Red Hat contribution and it provides the ability to pull messages off the journal, just like another event source, just like we are able to pull messages, for example, out of Apache log files. And this IamJournal we expect to be much less frequently used. It's for the enterprise use case and that probably is pretty useful. Let's have a quick look at the rsyslog input and output system. We have the rsyslog core engine right here in the middle, and we have on the left-hand side the inputs and on the right-hand side the output. And what we did is create these two modules over here and over there, and we use all the plumbing the rsyslog engine already provides, and thus we could edit relatively quickly and without much impact to the overall system. So let's first focus on low-end systems. Usually users of these machines are not interested at all in logging. So low-end system for me is in a home environment or a small office environment or for example a personal notebook where people use logging usually only for shorthand troubleshooting. If my Wi-Fi doesn't work, I go into the system log and check if there are some errors pertaining to it. But they are not interested in auditing, long time, archival, usually not in into intelligence based on the logs and all these things. In this environment, the journal is a very convenient tool as a troubleshooting tool. And as far as I understood it, that was the prime environment the journal folks had on their mind when they initially created it. Good thing here is definitely that the systemd status messages contain all these journal entries related to the process in question. And so that's probably very convenient. What we expect is that users would like to have some extra information into their journal logs, like, and that's probably the most important use case, their DSL routers, syslog messages. And the journal doesn't accept syslog natively, doesn't accept all the other protocols that rsyslog accepts natively. So you can actually use rsyslog as a bridge, accepting messages from the network and writing it to the journal files, and then use the journal tools to obtain the data. So that's our primary use case, and I've given a configuration, sample configuration file over here. In my opinion, this could even be the one and only configuration you need on such a, for example, low-end desktop, where we just load the IMUDP module over here, assuming that the low-end device DSL router does only provide UDP syslog. Then we load the OM Journal plugin to have the functionality that we need here. And then we just define a single input, the UDP listener at port 514, which is the default port that the device is sent to, and bind it to a single rule set. And that rule set over here does nothing but write everything that comes in, and that means everything that comes in via port 514, to the journal. And I can envision that this is probably the sole rsyslog conf that's needed on such a system. Maybe something that distros even begin to ship as a snippet. If you look at enterprise systems, things are a little bit different. It's, as I outlined in my other short presentation, it's impossible to manage an enterprise system without any syslogger, any other kind of message normalizer that something like our syslog is. So in this environment, we always have our syslog, and we will have syslog and a variety of other protocols. And the journal here is integrated as another event source, just another event source. I can envision, based on the experience we have with similar setups on Windows and the event log, I can envision that we will have journal-centric setups where as much as possible is done with the journal, and the integration happens at some central head servers inside the environment, maybe on a site based geographic region thing, or maybe based on some org chart thing. But it's more or less journal-centric. Do as much with the journal as possible, do the rest with syslog. Or just the opposite, syslog-centric approach, where the journal is used only as much as unavoidable, and each and every machine runs our syslog and forwards events via syslog mechanisms. Which mode is actually selected based on our experience with the event log depends much on the end user's philosophy, the end user's setup, devices, network infrastructure. So it's up to the end user, and it's hard to predict. From the event log point of view, it was always much more syslog centric than centric on the event log. But we'll need to see how this evolves on the journal. So how can we integrate journal data into syslog? We have this new module, the Red Hat contribution IAMJournal. It's loaded here. And essentially, that's everything that you need to do to obtain it, just like when you load the IMUX sock. You don't even need to start a specific listener, as there's only one and only journal on the system, so it just pulls that journal that's there. We have not given a full snippet, just something that makes a little bit of sense over here. This sample loads the journal, loads the JSON parser. It creates a CE lumberjack format template and runs everything that the journal receives to the JSON parser and sends it out to a CE log file in old style config given here. The key point to understand is IAMJournal is not necessarily needed to be run on a system because the journal forwards old-style syslog data more or less unmodified to the syslog daemon. So as long as you do not have any new applications that actually use the journal API, and they are currently close to none, there is no extra benefit in using IAMJournal. However, if the journal data is populated with metadata, with structured data that journal has decided not to forward to the syslog daemon, then you can use IAMJournal to get that data out of it and process it within your syslog relay chain. But again, in an enterprise environment, it doesn't make sense to give you a full sample like in the SOHO environment I had before. So this is just the building blocks I'm showing here, and it's not something that makes much sense in itself. So it needs to have an enterprise designer looking at it. Well, that's it. Finishing of the quick presentation. If you have feedback or questions, these days it's probably best to find me on Google+. I've also given a couple of links that are probably helpful over here. If you go to my blog, you also find the Google+ link. Yeah, thanks a lot for listening.